Alrighty, let's go with Chain of Memories. So it looks like that loading screen video was just a 30-second clip of the original Kingdom Hearts on the off chance you haven't seen it. I hope you've seen it. If you haven't, by the time this video gets onto YouTube, I will have done a Let's Play series of the original Kingdom Hearts where you can watch me play the whole thing. If you want the lowdown though, we were on an island, it got swallowed by darkness, we went chasing after our friends, we found them, bad shit happened, and now we're here. More details after this cutscene.
Along the road ahead lies something you need. However, in order to claim it, you must lose something that is dear to you.
Thank you. Hey, you think it's okay to barge in?
But we gotta do it if we can afford the king.
The king? King Mickey's here?
Something just told me he'd be here, okay?
Really? Because now that you mention it, I was kind of thinking the same thing.
Seriously? Me too. One look at this castle, and I just knew. Our very best friends, they're here.
Guess great minds think alike.
Wait, hey, hold on. It can't be just a coincidence.
Oh no, Timothy. You don't mean that.
Yep, I had it too. I had the exact same feeling.
Gorge! Maybe it's contagious!
No, something screwy! We gotta go take a look!
All right.
Where are you going?
That way, to the door. Are you scared?
Don't be ridiculous! Come on, let's go, Goofy!
Hey, fellers, shouldn't we shut the door behind us before we go? Sora!
That's it. Who are you?
What? Hi, yes. Oh, yeah? I'll try some magic. Thunder! Come on. Thunder! Thunder! Come on, Flizzard! Fire! Why isn't it working?
I should think it's obvious. The moment you set foot in this castle, you forgot every spell and every ability you ever knew. In this place, to find is to lose, and to lose is to find. That is the way. In Castle Oblivion.
Castle Oblivion?
Here you will meet people that you have known in the past. And you will meet people you miss.
I miss? Riku! You mean Riku's here?
If what you want is to find him,
huh? What'd you do?
I merely sampled your memories, and from them, I made this. To reunite with those you hold dear.
What's this? A card?
It is a promise for the reunion you seek. Hold the card to open the door, and beyond it a new world. Proceed, Sora. To lose and claim anew, or to claim anew. Only to lose.
Come on. Let's go.
Okay, we're done cutscening, and I get to poke the game now. So, left stick or directional button, select card to go to a world. I literally have one card, so I literally have one world to choose from. Very complex choice right now. I think I might go to Traverse Town. Keeping the tradition alive of starting the game in Traverse Town. I mean, we could have started in Destiny Island, that would have been even more copycatting the first game. This is not what Traverse Town looks like. I mean, the scenery is correct, but the layout is wrong. We are in Traverse Town. Good noticing there. Nearly calling Riku for a second. Sora. What I see isn't real. Well, great. We're doing well so far. This town is an illusion created by your memories ingrained in that card. My memories? That's what the guy said, Sora. Forget about that, Sora. We lost Donald and Goofy. That is not what Jiminy's voice sounds like at all. I should try and get some voices down so that if you're watching, you can at least tell who I'm talking about. Guys, where are you? Yeah, it's not Sora's voice either. Maybe I can do an ominous voice for Black Coat Man. What did you do with them? They are at the mercy of the cards now. It's ominous-ish, right? Master the cards and their strength will be yours again. I don't know. We're gonna try it for this playthrough. Well, sorry, this stream, not the whole playthrough. Alright, Black Coat Man is teaching me how to use my cards. The laws of this castle require that your friends be transformed into cards. If you value your friends, you won't fail to pick them up. Take your friends out for drinks. Left stick to move, right stick to move, look around. Just the basics. Cards you pick up are added to the top of your stack. Use them and your friends will come to your aid. Alright, this isn't intentional, but my voice to me sounds like Todd from Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. The fourth evil summon Donald, and he does a little bit of magic. And he vanishes again. Thanks, Donald. The cards you use vanish, but they will reappear to aid you time and again. Cards are the hearts of your friends. Everything in this castle is ruled by cards. Whether an enemy or a door confronts you, cards are the only way to proceed. But you mustn't forget your own strength. Can I hit him now? I have jump and dodge roll. Oh, I get to start with dodge roll, guys! Yes! Thank God. Having to unlock dodge roll is the worst. First, think for yourself. Move, then use the cards. Okay, yeah, but I'm just gonna run in and bash you. Nice. You now know how to use your strength, but it would be of no use if you lose sight of your opponent. I wonder if you can catch me. Come here, Black Coke dude. Black Coke? Black Cloak. R2 to lock on. Well, that's easy. Good. Yes, it was. Every move you make causes a card to disappear. If you use up all your cards, you will be unable to act. But there is a solution. Keep using cards until you run out, and I will show you. Alright, let's just go bash him. Even though it's not doing anything, it's satisfying to hit him and not just to swing at the air. Three cards left. Alright, now what?
You have no more cards, and without them, no power. If you want that power back, you must focus. Bid the cards return to you, and they will.
Okay, so you just hold down the X button, and it reloads your deck.
The strength of your heart brought back the lost cards. You can recall spent cards at any time. You only need wish it. But each time you do, the cards will take longer to return. The cards are by no means unlimited. Use them wisely. Anticipate the flow of battle and choose the most effective cards. You may use any card in your deck.
Okay, so L and R, we can cycle through our cards. And then we can... Okay, we just cycle through them.
The four card types you use in battle are grouped into two wider categories. The first category includes attack cards, magic cards, and item cards. The second category consists entirely of enemy cards. To use cards from a different category,
press the touchpad button. Oh, that's that big fat one in the middle of my PS4. Okay. I have a little heartless shadow card. I have no idea what I'm supposed to do with that. And it doesn't let me test it out. Okay.
Cards will empower you whether you are attacking or defending. But it is up to you to decide when to attack and when to defend. Do not forget that.
Wait, how do I defend? Hey look, Donald and Goofy are back. Are you two alright? Where have you been?
do tell us. When you opened the door, we saw a strange light.
That is not Donald's voice. Oh my god, I'm not doing that. I'm sorry. And the rest is just blank.
Jiminy says, gee, that doesn't help. Trying to remember what happened.
Okay, that's not a bad voice. I'll keep that one for Jiminy.
I have to keep my journal up to date.
Hey, Donald. Where'd I get the new clothes?
What? Me too, Goofy. Somebody's been messing with our clothes.
That voice is so wrong. I'm sorry.
Could it be the cards again?
That is for you to ponder. I've already lost the way I was doing the black coat guy's voice. Master the cards and make your way through the castle. But from here, you walk alone. Alone? We can't let Sora go alone.
Yeah, Sora can't do anything without our help.
Thanks a lot, Donald. Are you sure you'll be okay?
Of course.
You want me to go alone? Fine, I can take care of myself. The hero speaks boldly. Go then, the rest of Castle Oblivion awaits. Walk the avenues of latent memory, and you shall see someone dear to you.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Relax, Jiminy. I'm up for any tricks he's got up his sleeve. How hard can it be to figure out these cards? All I have to do is use one in front of that door over there. Okay, obtained the key of beginnings. Alright, strange voice acting is probably done until the next cutscene. Hopefully there's some in-game voice acting so you don't have to be subjected to me. I mean, I'm having fun. Alright, you can perform the following actions in the field. Left stick to move, right stick to look around, R3 to face forward. X to swing, circle to jump, square to dodge roll. Okay, just your basic generic moving around things. Striking objects reveals various... yields various results. Try striking the barrel. Sure! I'm up for mindless violence. I get a card, come back. Did I get it? Huh, I obtained Blizzard. Cool. Do I have to, like, equip it or anything? It's box. Marked objects can be lifted and thrown, press approach and press triangle. And what do you want me to do with it now that I've got it? Throw it at that heartless, apparently. And throw the box. I hit him.
Yeah.
And now hit him with my keyblade. There. Engage battle. I'm just standing there dumb. Cool. I mean, I say cool, but like, this is gonna be problematic when I run out of cards. If you watch me play the first Kingdom Hearts, I was really bad at actually hitting things. And it's even more problematic now, because it cost me a card each time. Alright. Card obtained. Tranquil Darkness. To open doors in the field, press triangle in front of the door. That's hugely complicated. Thank you for that tip. Wouldn't have got it without you. Alright, to proceed to the next room, you need a map card. I have a bunch of those. Map cards are used to synthesize new and unexplored rooms. First of all, select a map card you want to use. Left stick to select... yeah. X to confirm, circle to cancel, left right to switch card types. Pretty easy. So I have a Tranquil Darkness, I have a Moment's Reprieve, and I have the Key of Beginnings. And I can see that everything is grayed out except a Moment's Reprieve, so I guess I'll be using that. Oh, shit, I just jumped through a couple of menus. You need to pick a card that matches the criteria on the screen. Yeah, okay. Cards have values marked from 0 to 9. 0 cards are special cards which meet most criteria. Card without a marked value is key card, only used at special doors. Cool. Let's open our Moment's Reprieve. On without a save point. Stand near the save point, press triangle to open the save menu. Would never have gotten that without you. Thank you very much, instructions. Alright. Let us begin. As you can see, this is a blind playthrough. I have never played this game before. I played an emulated version when I was younger, but it was just really, really hard to work through. I struggled a lot with the controls, trying to run them on a keyboard on a very old computer, so
It was also not an emulated version of the, like, HD version that I'm playing now. It was the original Chain of Memories. This is re-Chain of Memories. Alright, let's do another door. I have a key card that I can't use, and I have Tranquil Darkness, so let's go through the door. Cool, welcome to the Tranquil Darkness room. It's not that tranquil, there's bad guys in it. Where did you go? I did not mean to do that. This is gonna take some getting used to these controls, because I just want to bash X and swing my sword. I don't want to think too much about this. Alright, I got another Tranquil Darkness, I got 3 experience. I'm gonna hit every single barrel that I see. Okay. Apparently I threw that barrel and it made the Heartless confused. But then when I went to attack him, my Sora got excited and asked for Lamp Post instead. What keeps happening? This is card break nonsense. Whack him with your sword, Sora. Oops, that's the heal button. That's the get you six back button. This is a lot more bad guys than I was prepared for, and I've just gained a level. Cool. Oh, Jesus. No, leave me alone. I have no power. Okay, now I have power again. Hit things. Come here. Let me hit you. Ooh, I have a friend card.
Donald.
Go, Donald. Yeah, okay. Yep. Okay, I keep having this thing come up that says card break, and I'm not enjoying it. Okay, Donald has a 6 on him, so surely he's powerful now. He just cast heal on me twice. That's not what I called you for. I need you to kill the bad guys. I mean, I appreciate that you're healing me, but not what I need you for right now. Okay, and hit this guy with my sword again. Start it. Stop doing that card break thing. Okay, now I have a card for Teeming Darkness. Yeah, I'm doing so well in the Tranquil Darkness, they gave me a Teeming Darkness. I'm going to... I don't know what these things mean yet. I'm gonna learn Sliding Dash. Okay, slide toward distant targets, as it says. Activate 3 attack cards of the same type with a value between 10 and 15. Okay. It is important to hit things before they hit you, because then you get to come in and whack them while they're standing still. And I like it when they're standing still. Oh, screw you and your bloody... So what I'm seeing is the number he has on the bottom of the screen is higher than the number of the card I'm trying to hit him with. I don't get to hit him. And I don't really have that many high-level cards. Hello, menu. What do I have? I have a Blizzard card I'm not using. Let's chuck that in, like, there-ish. And that's it. That's all I got in the way of cards. Okay. I'm gonna jump on this springy looking thing. Nothing happened. I'm gonna jump off this springy looking thing. There we go. Okay. I found a door. Yes. And a bad guy.
Yes.
Kill the bad guys before they wake up.
Freeze.
Ooh. Oh wait, I need to go get that friend card. Come here, Donald. There we go. No, stop it with your card break nonsense. My cards are such low level, I can't kill anybody.
Yeah, freeze.
Hold still, Shadow. There we go. And I got a strong initiative card. Okay, don't know what that's gonna do. Ooh, and another level. I still don't know what this stuff does. I'm gonna have health, because we know what health does. That thing I understand.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go through this cool-looking door, after we throw this box. Yeah. Which caused nothing to happen. Alright, going through the door. Doors emblazoned with a crown are special doors. I didn't notice that. You need a special card called key cards to open these doors. Having the key card isn't enough. You also need a key card and whatever the criteria card are. Pick map cards that meet the criteria and you can open the door. Easy. Hold up. Oh, crown. Right there, dead in the middle of the door. As opposed to that door, in the distance, it has no crown on it. Excellent. Alright, crown door. I'm gonna use my teeming darkness card, because that appears to make bad shit happen. Wait, do I want bad shit to happen now? I mean, look, logically, I'm about to go into a story room, so the story room is going to be preset, right? So it doesn't matter what I set it as with my cards. This is the theory. Let's go with that. See what happens. If it's a cutscene, there's going to be more voice acting. I'm so sorry. Fighting alone isn't as easy as I thought. Sora's voice is my voice, by the way. Oh well, Donald and Goofy just popped up. Don't pop out of nowhere like that.
Hey, it's not our fault. We don't know what's going on.
I'm sorry that Donald's voice sounds like... Thanks, Goofy. That was a real word that I had to make then. Pluto!
Hey, dog.
Pluto?
Things keep getting stranger. What's Pluto doing here?
Oh man, I'm really sorry. I can't do any decent Donald voice. There's nothing strange about that. We came to Traverse Town with Pluto, didn't we? That's supposed to be Goofy's voice, I didn't know.
Did we?
I've decided that Donald is very nasal.
No, wait!
That's supposed to be Jiminy Cricket's voice.
According to my journal, that was before you met Sora that you came to town with Pluto.
Maybe that would work better?
What? He's right! We were chasing after Pluto, and that's how we ended up in Castle Oblivion!
But aren't we in Traverse Town?
Well, not really Traverse Town. I think the card created this Traverse Town inside Castle Oblivion.
Who cares about that? It's all too confusing. I don't know where we are, but let's just keep moving forward to defeating the Heartless. We'll get somewhere. You better be careful, or it's the Heartless that are gonna defeat you. That is Leon has just wandered onto the scene. I wish this game had voice acting so I didn't have to try. I'm so sorry, everyone.
Leon, it's you. What are you doing in Castle Oblivion?
Castle Oblivion? What are you talking about? This is Traverse Town.
And how do you know my name? Who are you?
Leon, remember that big battle that we fought together?
I've never met the likes of you before. Quit playing, Leon. We fought the Heartless together. You know that.
Look, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't even know your names.
You don't?
Sorry.
I can't believe it. How could you have forgotten about us?
I feel for you, but you've got the wrong guy. Happens all the time. Don't take it so personally, Sora.
You do know his name!
Now, hold on. Why do I know your name?
Do you think Leon's just kidding around?
If he is, it's not funny. Sora's really upset.
Who's kidding around, Goofy? You and Donald are the ones who...
Hey!
I don't get it. Something's wrong with my memory. What's happening here? Oh, it's Yuffie. Okay. I'll come up with a voice for her in a sec.
She said she sensed some kind of uncanny power and asked us to look into it. Well, this is as uncanny as it gets. Maybe you should take Sora to see Aerith. Yuffie, you know my name. Yep, looks like you know mine too.
You know him?
Nope, total stranger. But I definitely know his name.
Strange, yes, but convenient. We can skip the introductions. I like this one. How is it you can accept this situation so easily? I don't get you. Well, I'm gonna run ahead and fill Aerith in. Leon, you give him the grand tour. See you later. I guess it's no use pondering over it. Come on, follow me. But there are heartless wandering around town. I better teach you how to protect yourself in battle. See the numbers printed on your cards? They range from 0 to 9. Higher numbers mean stronger cards. Yeah, I figured that out. If you and your enemy both play a card at the same time, the higher card wins. Go on, try it out.
Yes!
See how it works? Playing a higher card than your opponents and breaking through their defenses is called a card break. Playing a lower card results in your card being deflected. Even powerful cards can be deflected if the enemy's card is higher. Whoever is on the losing side of a break is left wide open to attacks. Don't let that person be you. Cards with zero as their value are special. No matter what card the enemy plays, you can break it with a zero card. But if you play the zero card too soon, the enemy can break it with any card they play. In other words, it's the most powerful card if it comes first, and useless if it comes... Wait, hang on, I said that wrong. In other words, it's the most powerful card if it comes last, and useless if it comes first. Coming first is always useless. Try and make the most of it. Card values also affect the cost of assembling a deck. Keep that in mind. Now it's time to teach you how to stop cards. You don't have to use battle cards one at a time. You can also assemble three cards and use them all at once. This is called stocking cards. Stocking cards and using them in threes is much stronger than using the cards individually. Go on, give it a try. Stock any three cards in your deck. Okay, so if we press triangle, we can shove them up, and if we press L2, it cancels. So if I put like a 7-7 and a 6, that's gonna kick his ass, right? The sum of your three stock cards becomes the value you play. The value is usually high and hard to break, and the combo attacks deal a lot of damage. Don't hold back, show me what you can do. Alright. L1 and R1 use 1 to 3 stock cards. Oh, okay, so if you press triangle, it uses all three. If you've only stocked like 2, you can bash L1 and R1 to use them. Combo attacks aren't the only benefit of stocking cards. Choose your cards carefully, and you can unleash special abilities called slights. Slights come in all varieties, and each has its own unique card combination. You should try it out once you've collected more cards and learned a slight or two. But keep one thing in mind. Every time you use stock cards, the first card you picked is lost. You can't reload it. The lost card won't return until the end of the battle. Relying only on slights will cause your cards to run out. That means trouble. Yes, I can imagine being in a boss fight with, like, 2 cards left. Like, help me, I'm dying. Think you've got the hang of it, Sora? Yeah, more or less. I'll pick up the rest when I fight some real battles. Here, I found this lying around. You take it. Remember what I told you, and make good use of it. What do I get? What do I get? What do I get? Simba. And I get the Key of Guidance, which is my next cutscene card. Alright. Let's firstly actually put Simba into the deck, which it doesn't seem to want to tell me about, so it's a good thing that I did this by myself. Let's chuck it there-ish. Okay. Shortcut button. I'll use that later. Okay. There's a map. What does the map tell me? Oh, cool. So the map tells you where you are, what rooms you've already unlocked, and it also shows you where to go. So that's where I came from, that's where I am, that's where I want to end up. Nice. Okay. Wait, what was that? Oh, I have deck 1 ready. Okay, sweet. So,
I don't have high jump, I have very low slow jump.
Freeze!
Alright, what does Simba do? Go, Simba! He rolls. Oh, and he knocked out, like, everyone. Nice. Oh, wow. Right, there's no point in stocking cards if they're all low-value cards. But, like, I guess if I stock a decent value card, and then chuck in some low-value ones, I get to a point where my low-value cards at least are slightly useful. Give me that friend card! Oh, you know what I can do? Is if I stock a friend card first, it probably won't matter that I wouldn't lose it, because you lose them anyway. Ah, look at me being sneaky.
Yeah, yeah. Freeze.
That's a plan. Let's see how that goes. Alright, I've obtained a Sleeping Darkness card. Oh, gee. Ah, I didn't see that shadow. Hit him! Got him.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't get him before he got me. Damn.
Courage.
This battle's really gonna mess with my, like, my basic approach is just to bash attack and, like, think later. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I'm not the most strategic person in the game. Yeah, that was only worth two, so it's really not surprising that it didn't work. Come on. There we go. Alright, got my cards back. It's also really important not to miss anything in this game, because, like, every time you swing costs you a card, so if you miss, you're really expensive.
Yeah. Power.
But yeah, using friend cards to lead stocks is really actually going to work really well. Because it does. Basically, there's a negative to stocking cards, which is it costs you a card to do it. But your friend cards you only get once anyway, so if I stock them, I really don't lose anything. Alright, I'm going to increase some CP as well. Good to keep things balanced. And we're going to go through into. So I need a 3 and up, so. I'm gonna go with a Sleeping Darkness. Maybe? Yeah. Makes the Heartless easier to kill, so I can get some practice with this weirdo card system in an easy way when I'm not fighting too hard. Because, yeah, I'm not a fan of this card system. I'm not gonna lie, it was pretty tricky to work with.
Donald!
I am a fan of stocking Donald at the start of a run. That seems to be pretty effective.
Power.
Ooh, quick, get the next Donald card! I can see him bouncing around in the background. I want to go get him. Where'd he go? There it is. Oh, I lost it! Damn it! Okay. That's annoying.
Yeah, heal!
I mean, on the upside, they're just shadows, which makes them not too hard to whack with my little keyblade. I obtained a premium room. Whatever that means. Ooh, who do I want to throw this at? That guy. Oh, what? Damn it. Oh no, he's unconscious anyway. Cool. I can hear cards bouncing around. Oh, that was it. There was literally two of them. That was great for experience, right there, having two things to attack. Actually, this kind of room is really cool, because there's just a bunch of Heartless standing around, unconscious, like, waiting for me to hit them. Okay, Blizzard is great and all, but you actually have to aim it properly. I don't like these guys, because they actually have really... Like, 4 is not a very high-numbered card, but the game just started. I don't have very many high-numbered cards either. I've got a Stagnant Space card. I don't know what that does, but I guess it'll be useful when I get to it. Yeah, I'm gonna fight all these Heartless because they're easy experience right now. And easy experience at the start of the game. Oh, I totally didn't need to stock cards then. There was one guy left and he had like half a health point. Oh well. Just try and hit him with my sword, not just headbutt him. Is that it? Oh, come on, I had two friend cards. I was gonna stack them and see what happened. Okay, cool. Take out these boxes for some points. And, oh, I got another cure card. Nice, that's gonna be useful. And that is another kingdom key. How many more cards can I have in my deck? 272 out of 300, so probably not many. But if I just chuck cure and this one more key... Oh wait, I'm already over. Damn. Okay, well... This means I have to take a couple of cards out. How do I do that? Aha! By pressing that button. And I need to take 19 CP out, so I'm going to take out this kingdom key. Like, I know a zero is technically very good, but it's also technically very bad, because it's really hard to time using it properly. And it's just a swing with the sword, it's not anything great. Okay, so, I'm going to get rid of... No, I'm not. I can't get rid of this Teeming Darkness card. And I like the Sleeping Darkness, I'm going to keep that for later. Stagnant space is a room where the Heartless moves slowly. I can't use that one anyway. Okay, I'm gonna use my Tranquil Darkness card then. And this card that unlocks the next key. The next story event. Oh, there are too many people to do their voices. Okay, we're gonna try. Aerith, have you forgotten me too? I don't know whether to say nice to meet you or good to see you again. I don't think I know you, but I still feel like you belong here. Yeah, exactly. Like, we've never met, but it still doesn't feel weird knowing your name. But I'm telling you, we have met. We took on the Heartless together. We're a team. It feels like you're right, but I can't remember. Then I guess you won't remember what you told me. In Hollow Bastion, when I sealed the keyhole. We may never meet again. But we'll never forget each other. See, you do remember. He's right, Leon. I remember you saying that too. I guess I can't write it off as a coincidence, then. I don't have a memory of it, but somehow I still remember. I think your heart is doing the remembering for us. My heart? We don't know you, Sora, but your heart is full of memories of us together. Those memories must resonate in our hearts, too. Maybe they tell us things we couldn't otherwise know. So you're saying that Sora's memories are affecting ours? His memories do seem to have a certain power. Maybe it's like that guy said, then. This town is just an illusion, something my memories created. And there's someone special to you in this town? How do you know? Oh, I get it. My memories are resonating with yours, telling you what happened. Yeah, a friend of mine is somewhere in this town. I mean, Castle Oblivion. Castle Oblivion? What's that? There aren't any castles here. That's not quite what I mean. You're still not sure what's going on yourself, right? Right. We just got here, after all. I want to take a better look around. Then go have a walk around the town. There are Heartless, but that's no problem for you. So you know I can fight. I can't say I know, but I feel like believing you. Let's leave it at that. New card obtained. Key to truth. Alright. So there's literally nothing here because I have already cleaned out this room, so we'll just go to the next one. I don't have another one of those cool sleep- Oh no, yeah, I have another one of those cool sleepy cards. Oh, and I can't use it because I need a 5 and up. No premium room, no teeming darkness. I can either use Alchemic Awakening, where my item cards are more effective, but the only one I have is that potion, so that doesn't matter. Or Tranquil Darkness. I'll use Tranquil. And I have 2 of those anyway, so... Okay. Whoop. Oh, Jesus, the bad guys. They sneak up on you a lot better in this one. Can I... Nope. I can miss entirely is what I can do.
Funnel!
Yeah, stacking a friend card at the front of a slide is really effective. Oh, you actually have to go and collect your experience. Those little blue things are over there are your experience points. You don't just like get them for free.
Deal.
Damn you and your card breaking. Alright, let's go. There we are. Nice. Okay, I got another Tranquil Darkness card, I got another level. So CP lets me have more cards, HP keeps me from dying. I'll go for some CP, because I haven't had any trouble staying alive yet. Jump, and... Oh, I did not hit him in time.
Nope.
I've just come from playing the original Kingdom Hearts, where R1 was lock on. And in this, R1 shifts you so that you're on the, what's it called? So you're on the restock thing? So I keep hitting it, and like, just being entirely in the wrong thing and not actually able to do any damage. There's a friend card, give me that. Nice, thanks Goofy. That was really effective actually. And I just wasted a bunch of cards because they were low level and I wasn't paying attention. Well done. Good work, punch yourself. What have I got? I put that restock card. Kinda need that right now. Well, guess who's got a friend? And whack those two. Nope. Oh man. My cards are so weak. It's really hard to get anything done. What do we got now? There we go. And I got a strong initiative room card. So every battle I fight, I seem to get room cards. Oh my god, is that another symbol? Nice. Putting that in my deck. So I currently have a zero card that I'm not using and a Simba. It's only 3, so he's not as good as the last one, but I will have him anyway. Yeah, okay, so when you add cards to your deck, it only, like, pushes them down, it doesn't kick them out, so... And that's using 324 CP out of 325, so that's good. Oops. Just realized I climbed up here, and that's where I want to go, is actually back down the bottom. Damn it, I did it again! Gotta stop doing that. I really don't think I needed to summon Singer. Wrong way. Got him. That was a really awkward fight. And I got a card key to a black room. That sounds dramatic. On the upside, if you don't hit the bad guys and they hit you first, on the upside, you don't get stunned. They get stunned when you hit them, but the reverse doesn't happen.
Power.
You summon Simba when I tell you to, because otherwise you're gonna get hurt. And then we're gonna use Heal real quick. And do that trick again.
Funnel!
Yeah. Thanks, Donald. Doing the hard work for me. Okay. I think that's all the bad guys in this area. Maybe. Maybe, maybe, maybe. Oh, wait. One more. Which I again didn't manage to hit before the battle started. It's actually harder than I thought it would be to hit guys before the battle starts.
Courage! Final!
And yes, I did just waste my 3-point Simba card on a slight, but that's because it's just so little. It's kind of not worth trying to hang on to, because every time I use it, it's getting broken. So it's just getting interrupted, and I've just wasted my effort putting it out. Oi, mate. I didn't say you could do that. I'm still not sure how I feel about this card system, because technically, if you're doing something that complicated, it should be a turn-based system. So, is it me being a bit shit, or is it the fact that they've made it... I don't know, it requires a lot of paying attention, and a lot of quick fingers. Okay, so I need to use a green card that is 6 and up. What do I have? I have this Alchemic Awakening card. Okay, that's the one that makes items more effective that I really don't need, because I don't have that many items, so get rid of that. And I probably should have paid more attention, because that was the Heartless Emblem on that card, which makes me feel like this is going to be a boss fight. I'm not ready for that. Oh, I can't do another gravelly man voice. Well, what do you know? It's Sora. Nope, that's the voice I used on the, Okay, gravelly man voice.
Wait, what am I saying? I don't know you.
Okay, that's his voice now.
But you do look like a Sora. What with the spiky hair and the baggy pants.
Yeah, every man voice I do, they're just pack-a-day smokers. It's okay, Sid, that's my name. Except Sora, he's a kid, he doesn't get a man voice.
So, you've heard of me.
Anyway, maybe you can help me out. A friend of mine is supposed to be somewhere in this castle or town. Got any ideas?
Your friend, huh? Lately this town sees as heartless. Can't take two steps without getting attacked. In fact, this plaza's the worst.
Well, great place to stop for a chat, then.
Word is, a jumbo so it's heartless shows up when that bell rings. If you value your hide, you'll get out of here while the getting's good.
He does sound like a space pirate, even without my bad voice acting. Gorsh, maybe we should leave too. Don't you want to see the Heartless? Why would I ever want to see a Heartless?
No, we don't!
Yeah, good choice, Donald. And there goes the battle, so we're gonna see it anyway.
The bell!
Be careful, Sora! Well, aren't you gonna help? You guys are here too. And then they just like disappear in a puff of smoke because that's the rules of Castle Oblivion. Alright, let's use the lock on button, not the rotate cards button this time. Okay, lock on. We're gonna get a lot of card breaks happening here. Oh no, man. Hang on, there's a friend card. And I missed it. Ouch. There we go. Can't break that one. My boss fight technique might just degrade into roll around a lot and see what I've got in the way of cards that can break him. Nope. I'm out of cards that are any good already. Yeah. You know what I do have though is a heal. That works. I'm trying to dodge roll away from him and I'm literally like trapped by his feet. Okay. What I would really like is some friend cards now. That would help a lot.
Freeze! Power!
He's such a tease. He'll, like, say he's going to attack you with a low card, and then he'll, like, bring out a high card when you put out a low card. What a tease. Ooh, friend card! Friend card! Go get it, Sora! No, don't get beaten up, go get the friend card! Oh, God. No, it's gone. There it is, there it is! No, we lost it. Oh. When he's using a 2 and I use a 2, my 2 should be better. Alright, we knocked him down. Hit him. Hit him while you can. Hit him while he's down. Alright, I see another friend card bouncing around in the distance and I missed out on again, man. Ouch. Go away with your big bouncy feet. Go on, choose a smaller card.
Courage.
Hopefully this game gets to a point where I can be a bit smarter than just running. Because right now my technique is run. Yes, I have a friend. That's what I want.
Goofy!
Oh!
Goofy smash!
Yeah! 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 Ha! Heal!
Oops. Keep forgetting I have those. Friend card? Give me a friend. There's also not a defend button, which is a bit iffy. Like, what am I supposed to do when there's no defend button? Oops, not what I wanted to use. I can see a friend card bouncing in the distance, let me go get it! Priorities here! Give me that! Yes. And now I can't see what I'm doing. No, lock onto him. Okay. I can't stock that card, that's not fair. But I can use it to break in. Oh, the King Mickey card is what drops him down and says. Crap. I don't want to use Simba when he comes up anymore, huh? Where'd he go? There he is. I can't break your 3 right now. Yes, I can. I can break your cards by healing myself. Okay, I've got the card that makes him fall down. Aha! I can use my heals to literally stop him doing what he's doing. That's kind of cool. Okay. That was very much a, like, introduction to boss fights. Because I learned some stuff, and I played not too terrible towards the end. But the start of that was a whole lot of runaway and panic. But we're learning. You can definitely see that this is not going to be an easy game to go into if you're underleveled. You really can't just defend and hide in the background. You have to kind of... you have to be on the ball. Time for more voice acting! This is when we realize that Leon and Sid have the same voice. So, your friend wasn't here? No, I don't think I'll find him in this town. But he's somewhere in this castle, I just know it. Castle? Like, the whole town's inside some humongous castle. Ooh, that's rich. Wait, who's saying that? Leon's saying that.
He's probably right, Sid. We may not understand what's going on, but Sora does. He can see that reality is bigger than just this world.
I wish I was that sure.
You'll be okay, Sora. No matter what shape reality takes, you can handle it. I may not remember you, but I know you in my heart.
I just had to grab my chest when I said that.
Leon!
Take care, Sora!
I'm a little lost, but best of luck anyway.
That was Sid. Bye, friends. Get off my screen so I don't have to try and voice act you anymore. Doing 7 voices is not easy, and I won't even pretend that I have any level of skill at that. What's up?
I don't have all the answers, but I had to tell you something.
Your memories created this town, right? That's what the guy who gave me the card said. If that's true, then this town is just a figment of your mind, and so are we. Wow, that's comforting. But you can't be a figment. You're just standing right here. This town is too. But I'm not real. I don't remember the things I should, and I sense things I shouldn't. Sora, beware of your memories. In the journey to come, you'll be faced with more illusions. Sometimes the shadows of your memory will deceive you, to try and lead you astray.
So, what exactly does that mean?
I'm sorry, I'm just another illusion. The truth is out of my reach.
Taking advice from illusions.
Don't say stuff like that, it's depressing. Stay strong, Sora. Don't let the illusions distract you from what's truly important.
Okay.
Sora!
I don't know who's yelling at me from the distance. It's Donald.
Are you ready to go?
Yeah, be right there.
Well, I better be going.
And poof, Aerith is gone. Aerith? Aerith!
What about Aerith?
Where did she go? I was just talking to her.
Aerith left with Leon and the others, remember?
Huh?
You worried us just standing there talking to yourself.
Is that what she meant?
In a space called the Conqueror's Respite. Go.
Got barrels for me to hit. Keep getting Moogle points. I don't know what they are, but I have them. I'll figure out what they are later. If it's a Conqueror's Respite, surely it's got a save point in it, right? There's some banners on the wall with a 3 on them, whatever that means.
Ha! A save point.
And some more barrels. Give me those points that I don't know what they do.